You remember that time I talked about stem cells? Oh, I remember. Hey, cellmates, Julian here for DNews. We've been cranking out episodes for 4 years now, can you believe it? Over the course of the next few days, the hosts from DNews are going to celebrate our birthday by having a look back and revisiting topics from our first days with the show. I've talked about a ton of fascinating stuff, but I still remember my first episode when a fresh-faced and over-enthusiastic me couldn't wait to tell you about an exciting new experimental treatment involving stem cells, cells which can take the form of other tissues and hold the promise of regenerative medicine. Since then, what's been going on in the world of stem cells? Well, a lot. Like, a lot. Hardly a week goes by without stem cells making a headline for one thing or another. Here's a brief sample of some from the last 2 years. Scientists successfully created mouse eggs from stem cells that produced healthy young pups when fertilized. Stem cell therapies on people with traumatic brain injuries appear to reduce the body's neuroinflammatory response, saving brain tissue. And cardiologists are testing stem cells as a treatment for a type of heart failure that kills half its victims within 5 years and previously had no treatments at all. Oh, did I say that those were headlines from the last 2 years? Because I meant they were from the last 2 weeks. So obviously the pace and variety of stem cell research is immense. Looking back to my first episode though, we focused on what was then a new treatment for vision loss caused by macular degeneration. That's when part of your retina starts to deteriorate. It wasn't the first time stem cells had been used to treat macular degeneration. In fact, a month after my DNews debut, a report published in The Lancet followed up on 18 cases of patients who had stem cell procedures on their eyes up to 3 years prior. The patients showed no signs of rejection or tumor growth, and for 13 of them, their vision had improved on average about 3 lines on the eye chart test. You know, the one with the huge E that after that everything's just smudges? Anyway, the story I covered was special because it was the first use of induced pluripotent stem cells, or iPSCs, on a human. The cells were made from the patient's own skin that had been turned back into stem cells using a virus that delivered new DNA. Before that, scientists used embryonic stem cells, which may have a risk of rejection, to go along with a thorny ethical dilemma. Sadly, the woman who received the induced stem cell treatment remains the only person with that distinction. The researchers had a second procedure planned, but halted it when two small mutations in the cells made them worry they would lead to tumor growth. That hasn't been the end for iPSCs. In fact, they've become invaluable for laboratory work. They've been useful for drug screenings, and scientists can study diseases by introducing mutations to the cells using the breakthrough gene editing technique CRISPR. And because iPSCs are so similar to embryonic stem cells, but can be produced easily and ethically, stem cells are in a much greater supply than ever before. In fact, their creator, Shinya Yamanaka, isn't resting on his Nobel laurels. Using a protein called BMP, or bone morphogenetic protein, he discovered a way to turn adult cells into stem cells more frequently. This can increase the supply and further accelerate and diversify the research. So 2 years on, nobody else has received treatment using induced pluripotent stem cells, but that doesn't mean there's been no progress. Scientists are finding new and interesting uses for them all the time, but they're going slow and making sure the treatment won't do more harm than good. Like we always say, more research is needed. We all have embarrassing pictures of us from when we were younger, but I am not ashamed. There is my first DNews episode right there. Epic flail. Are there any other old DNews episodes that stick out in your mind you'd like us to follow up on? Go ahead, tell us about them in the comments, subscribe for more, and I will see you next time on DNews.